Today we're going to use Tinkercad to rotate and flip things, so let's get cracking. Friends, this is Tinkercad. You can find it by visiting tinkercad.com. I always choose sign in with Google. Today, friends, we're going to start with the very basics. Let's hit create new 3D design. One of my first steps when I open a project is to name it. This is going to be called rotate and flip. Once you click down here, that is saved. If you click right here, it takes you back to the Tinkercad dashboard. There is our project. Right now, there's nothing in it, so there's no thumbnail. We can re-enter this project by simply hitting Tinker This. When working in Tinkercad, we can work with all sorts of basic shapes. There are many more, but once again, this is just for beginners, so we're going to highlight the basics. To work with objects, we simply drag them out onto the works plane. We can click on the item and select it. If we do Control D and then use the arrow keys, you can see there are two. If we do Shift Nudge, it moves 10 times as far. You can determine how far it moves with the snap grid. If I set that to 5, now each tap moves it much further. I'm going to set it back to size 1, just so I'm keeping you on the basics. And today we're going to work on rotation. Now the first thing I want to show you is we can rotate our views. We can click on these corners, we can look at it from the top. You can also right click with your mouse and drag the world around. Once again, this is orbiting our project. Now the other kind of rotation is object rotation. If you look at it, there are handles here. We can see two real easily. If we change our directions, boom, we can find the third. These are for the different axes that we work in. I'm going to quickly take this one and I'm going to show you how to rotate. If you stay inside this blue circle, this is called the widget. Notice it moves 22.5 degrees per turn. I have just moved it 90 degrees. If I move my mouse a long ways away, it moves 1 degree at a time. So if we wanted to stand this up, we would have to go to 90. You can also hold the shift key and then it rotates 45 degrees per click. Notice that is rotated, but it is not on the work plane. If we hit D to drop, it is now standing. If you wanted this to have these two points touching, we would then switch to this rotation handle. And if you move over here to the 22.5 degree, notice that's too far. If we back it back to 19 or 18, that looks pretty good. Once again, though, this is just guess and check. There is not an automatic way to figure that out. Now, if you wanted two of these connected to each other, what you would do is do Control D, and I'll do Shift Nudge to move it back away so that you can see it. And of course, we could rotate it 180 degrees, but I'm going to show you that if you miss, like say I went 160, that didn't line up. So I'm going to do Control Z, which is undo. And friends, the coolest way to make that happen is to just use the sweet mirror tool. Bam! It is now the exact opposite of what it was. And then to connect these together, we're going to hit W for work plane. We're going to set the work plane right there. And now when we click on this, we can do D to drop. Bam! You've just taken those two different shapes and you use rotate to spin them, and then you use the mirror tool to flip them. I'm going to hit W for work plane and set that back on the normal work plane area. And I just want to show you another place where this can be handy. If you bring out the sketch tool, notice it fits right in that grid area. It's got the dotted line right in the center of the line. It lines up perfectly with the shape. What we're going to do is we're going to make a super symmetrical heart. Instead of straight lines, we're going to use Bezier curves. I'm going to get there with the shortcut key 2. I'm going to click right here, and then I'm going to go halfway across this. I'm going to hold and pull to move this out, and then I'm going to come down to this spot here. Once again, I'm going to hold and pull to get the exact arch that I want, and then finally, I'm going to connect it over here. I am going to connect this not perfectly. I'm just going to accept what it gave me, and then I'm going to connect this. I did that so that we could double click to edit it, and now I can click on this shape and show you the different handles. These are smooth, so notice they stay connected. That's a pretty cool heart. I'm going to do Control Z though, and instead I'm going to make this into broken handles. Notice now they have dotted lines, and I can take this one and move it independently of the one above to get the exact heart shape I want. When I've got something that I think looks fantastic, and I'm going to accept this one right here, I'm going to hit Finish Sketch. So because we've got half a heart, we can simply do Control D. I'm going to do Shift Nudge to move it across, and then once again, bust out the sweet mirror tool to flip it just like that. Once again, to connect the two in half, I'm going to hit W for work plane, set it right here, and do D to drop. W for work plane, set it back to the original. Let's select those two shapes and do Control G to group. Bam, you have an instant perfect heart. Of course, you can click on your objects, pick any color, have a ton of fun as you make awesome objects in Tinkercad. Now I do want to quickly highlight, if you make something fantastic, you can share it with the world as well. Simply return to the Tinkercad dashboard. Notice now it has the images of what we built. And then we simply click this gear, choose properties, give it a name we like. Of course, in the description, you can say whatever you want. Mine is going to have that the tutorial's coming soon. And then, of course, I added some tags. Don't forget the HLMT23 tag. If you give that tag to any design, I will check it out and I will give it a reaction. Finally, don't forget, if you want everybody to see your design, you can make it public. By default, they are yours and yours alone, but when you click that, the whole world can see it. You can let users use your project, or you can set it to no derivatives if you want them to just see it and not use it. I'm going to leave mine to share alike and simply hit Save Changes, prove I'm not a robot, and hit Submit. If we click up here on the gallery, the first thing you see are the awesome staff picks. Of course, when you get a chance, click on them and of course, give a reaction. If you scroll down just a little bit, you should be able to track down one of mine. Of course, reactions are appreciated and quite often you will find a tutorial. Also, if you look below, you'll find other awesome projects. Real quickly, I just searched the HLMT23 tag. Check it out. There is our rotate and flip project. Absolutely love seeing all these projects shared. Check out this one by Hannah's Creation. This is a tutorial of mine and it was created lately. Love that we can click view in 3D and check it out from every direction. Fantastic work, Hannah. Of course, reaction given. Here's an extra bonus. Friends, when you click on a user's name, you can instantly see all their awesome projects. Of course, once you click on them, make sure you check them out. If you want, hit view in 3D and also give a reaction. Once again, great work, Hannah, and thanks for sharing. Friends, as I wrap up, once again, thanks for watching. I will let you know I have day one tutorials. They'll be listed up above. I also want to say thank you to everybody that support me via YouTube memberships. Three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. One of my favorite perks is you get early access to videos. Friends, I do also want to say thank you to everybody supporting me via Patreon. Love how that group is growing. The messaging area is absolutely fantastic. You can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day. And keep tinkering.